In this video, I'm going to answer the age-old question that you've been asking yourself. How much does it cost to build a WordPress website? Before I answer the question, we have to set some context because a website can mean anything. It's like asking the question, how much does it cost to build a home? Well, the answer is going to be absolutely different if it's a farmhouse, if it's a single family home, a condo, or a mansion, because a house can mean anything. Similarly, a website can mean anything. Technically, Google.com, Amazon, Facebook, and other big services that you have used in the past are also websites, but obviously they cost millions of dollars to make and maintain. So in this video, we have to set some context before we understand how much does it cost to build a WordPress website. And in the context of this video, we'll be talking about what does it cost to build a simple WordPress website, a little more complex WordPress website, an e-commerce website, and even a custom WordPress website. All of these questions will be answered in this video. So all you have to do is subscribe, follow, and watch this video till the end. So let's start by discussing what does it cost to build a simple WordPress website. And we'll do that by breaking down the components required to build a simple WordPress website. Essentially, you just need a handful of components. So the first thing you need is a software to run the website, which is WordPress, and it's absolutely free. So no cost there. On top of that, you'll need hosting, a domain name, a theme to have a design on your website, and also some essential plugins. Let's break down the cost of each of these components to estimate what does it cost to build a simple website and operate it for an entire year. As I already mentioned, WordPress, the software required to run your website, is completely free, so there are no costs there. Then comes the hosting, which can typically cost between $7 to $15 a month. Then comes the domain name, which costs around $15 a month for a typical domain name. Next comes the themes and plugins, and thankfully WordPress has a large repository of plugins and themes that you can utilize for free. There are literally thousands of themes available which you can pick from and install on your website with no cost associated. Last I checked, there are 59,000 plugins available in the WordPress repository. Obviously, this is a huge number, so here are top recommendations of the plugins you should have on a typical WordPress website. You should install WP Forms for adding contact forms on your website, Monster Insights to get analytics about what users are consuming data, what users are doing on your website, Seedprod for designing beautiful looking landing pages and pages in general, WP Code for adding code snippets on your website, and Duplicator for backing up your website. Obviously, the choice of plugins you want to add on your website will depend on the kind of functionality you want to have on your website, but this is a typical list. For details about different kinds of plugins you can and you should have on your website, I recommend watching this video, which I'll link in the description of this video and also as an end card. So watch it for the end. So to conclude, a simple WordPress website can cost anywhere between $100 and $200 per year to build and operate. But if you want to save some extra money on top, you can sign up with Bluehost, which is our recommended partner for hosting. They'll give you hosting for up to 60% off on the regular pricing, and also you'll get 1 year domain name for absolutely free. So save some money, go in the link in the description and figure out this deal. So now that you know what it costs to build a simple WordPress website, let's also talk about what it takes to build a little more complex website with a little more features. Essentially, only two things will change. The first can be the hosting. If you want to build a more complex website, it might require a little more resources. For that, we recommend you opt for SiteGround. Again, we have a partnership deal with SiteGround and they'll give you 60% off for the first year. So go to the link in the description if you want to build a little more complex website. If you're not planning on adding a lot of functionality to your website, then Bluehost might be just fine. It's your call. The second thing you might need to take a look at and also update is the list of plugins that you install and also upgrading to some premium versions of existing plugins. As I mentioned, you might be using plugins like WP Forms, All-in-One SEO, Monster Insights, Duplicator, and depending on the complexity of your platform, depending on what you're trying to build, you might decide to upgrade to premium versions of these platforms. So depending on the complexity, depending on the features you plan to add on your website, a complex website for WordPress can cost anywhere between $200 to $50 a year to up to $1,000 a year, depending on these plugins and what choices you make by adding these plugins on your website. Similarly, the cost of building and operating a small business website are quite similar, somewhere between $300 a year to up to $1,000 a year. The only difference between a business website and a simple website is the choice of plugins you'll have. A business website might require different features, unique features, or sometimes even more features. So the only extra costs you'll accumulate over the regular costs that I already mentioned are just some premium features or premium plugins that you'll need to purchase. So again, the pricing budget will fall somewhere between $300 to $1,000 for a small business website as well. So now that you know what it costs to build a simple website, a complex website, and even a small business website, let's talk about what does it cost to build an e-commerce website. Well, theoretically, an e-commerce website is very much like a simple website or a complex website with a little more features on top. So that's the only cost you'll have apart from some business compliance needs that you'll need. For example, you'll need an SSL certificate, you'll need a payment processor, and you need additional functionality on your website to process payments, to understand customer lists, also provide some automations, send invoices, and all the regular e-commerce things. And most of these things will be achieved by either installing specific plugins or upgrading to premium versions of the plugins that we've already discussed. You don't need to start paying at lots of money for the hosting. The essential hosting that I've mentioned from SiteGround or Bluehost will survive. So don't need to have additional costs just for hosting. To give you an educated guess, an e-commerce website can cost anywhere from $1,000 to $3,000 per year to operate and run, depending on the plugins and other functionality you want to have on your e-commerce website. So now that you know the relative cost of building all these different websites, let's also talk about the last thing here, which is what does it cost to build a custom WordPress website? There's a little twist, so make sure to watch the entire section. When we talk about custom websites, we usually think about large enterprises, established businesses, because they have specific requirements which cannot be fulfilled by off-the-shelf plugins, and they might have security requirements, or they have very specific design requirements that they might need. So in that case, they'll go for managed hosting, which can cost hundreds of dollars a month, and also hire developers to build this design and also the functionality on the site. Now, since we cannot define what's the design requirements and what's the functionality requirements, it can cost anywhere between $5,000 to up to $50,000 to build a custom website. But there's a silver lining. If your definition of custom website is just a custom theme, depending on your brand, depending on your style, or something you already had in mind, that can be achieved for less than 90% of the cost that I just mentioned. Because if you just want to customize the design elements of WordPress, then there's a fantastic plugin called Seedprod that you can install on your website. It's a fantastic drag and drop builder, and what it allows you to do is design the custom website or perfect website based on exactly how you want to do it without even touching a line of code. Even if you're not a designer yourself, you can hire someone at a fraction of the price that I just mentioned to design the dream website that you've always wanted. So it doesn't cost $50,000 or more to build a custom website if you just want a custom design on your website. If you're a large business or enterprise, yes, it can cost that much money. So that's the end of the video. If you want to learn how to build a website, watch this video right here. And if you want a list of essential plugins that you should have on your website, you can watch this video right here. Don't forget, you can go to the link in the description and sign up for Bluehost or SiteGround and start building your website today. This is Yuvraj from WBeginner, and I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.